Okay, so. Just finished filming my Mission Inspiration for October, the Halloween one. And I'm going to jump straight in with this page. Down the centre to protect the pages, stop the book falling apart. It's the first time I've used this washi tape. Okay, let's see if I can match it back up. Doesn't have to be perfect, it's just swinging over that. There we go. That's a little bit off the bottom. Okay. And now I am going to use it just to highlight this definition. We've got vampire and vampire bat together, and I'm going to pop this. Around. There. Now, what colour are we going to do in the background? How about red? Should we have a reddish colour? I think what I'm going to do first is grab a bit more tape just to cover up another definition that I can see on this page that I don't particularly want. Didn't see that before. Make sure there's nothing else on here that I'm worried about. It's the only thing we're using dictionary paper or book paper. Gotta check what's on it. Right. So I think first of all I'm going to grab some clear gesso and we'll pop that on. And then I'll dry it and I'll come back. You don't need to see me paint clear gesso on, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I think I'm going to go with this Crafter's Choice Royal Lankel Purple, which is not very purple to me. It's got quite a reddish purple tone. So, just going to paint that over. Okay, so I have actually done a page before about bats, vampire bats. Where is it? That's my Mission Inspiration page, still trying. This one. But this is for emphasis on the vampire. So I did purchase the newest anti-queering sticker book, Bibliophilia, which is, I thought it was going to be a bit more about books. It's quite similar to the other one, but it does have this fantastic quote from Dracula, which is going in here. Add some glue to that, but I'm going to pop it there just for a sec, and then I'm going to go into the actual anti-grooming sticker book. And there's a page in here that has a lot of bats on it somewhere. But right. So I do want to grab these bats out and cut the edge away. So I'll speed through that for you. Okay, so I have my bats cut out, my quote. So I need some glue. Let's go with the elmers again. As I was cutting the bats out, I remembered, wasn't he talking about the wolves howling at that point? I can't remember. I have read the book a while ago. It's a great book. I feel like he was talking about wolves then. But I think in most adaptations of the book, he's talking about the bats when he's bats are the creatures up right, aren't they? So I want this one over. I need a little bit more glue there. Down this side here. Whoop. I struggle in that fold a little bit, but that's okay. Try and tease it down a little bit. Right. Now, do I have a stump that we can use to sort of fill in some of the background? I think actually I have, yes, I have this one, which will be nice. Tim Holtz, is it? Stamp is Anonymous, yeah, Tim Holtz, had it in my collection. It's quite an old one. And I'm going to use my black archival. Just pop those out of the way, get loads of ink on there. Try and get a nice stamp. Stamping in a book. Okay. Just quickly stamp this. Doesn't matter if some are a bit fainter than others, it just adds to the field of perspective. And there we go. A little bit more up there. I'm going to leave that for a minute and I'll be back shortly. Okay, so I have this Sarah Hurley stamp and that one as well, so we'll have one of those. If I can get into the packaging, there we go. I think I'm nearly done with this page. So, let's see. About there. Oh. There we go. Not a great stamp. Then let's try it this way. Actually, take it off the block. Right. Okay. Okay. And then I think I'm just gonna put a little cheeky bite me down there. That sucks. There we go. And then one just going to finish the page. I think let's pop that away. Excuse the noises for a second as I just dig for a pen. Page. Just finish it off. I would have liked a good vampire on this page. The only ones I can find are kind of cutesy ones. If I find one, I might add it on. But for now, all this page done once I've just done this little bit. Excuse my hand in the way. There we are. Maybe just here, a little Dracula or something. Cover up. Could maybe put him, oh, maybe there. I feel like I might have to stamp him onto some sticker paper and pop him there, so I'll be back. I think I'm going to colour him. He's not going to need a lot of colour, is he? Because he's supposed to be pale. So maybe just a little bit of crayon, pencil crayon on the lips and the eyes. So I'll be back when I'm ready to stick him on. There we are. I always get it the wrong way. So I've stamped him, I've coloured him, I've given him a very faint skin tone colour with a little bit of purple under his eyes. I've also given him some pupils because I thought it looked a bit that way. So we're going to pop him there. So it's not right in the centre. There we go. Perfect. Now then, let's add the date. Today is the 1st of the 11th, 21. And this year is just flying by. It's frightening. Okay, so I am considering doing some more Halloween pages now and saving them for next Halloween. We'll see. My battery's flashing at me, so I'm going to go now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you again soon.